Hey, how's it going, YouTube? I'm back in the video, and today I'm going to be talking about why the Houston Rockets could be in huge trouble going into their future and just maybe even into next season. As many of you probably know, Russell Westbrook has demanded a trade from the Houston Rockets. Now, although he hasn't been traded yet, there is a very high chance he will be traded away from the Houston Rockets, and they probably won't be able to get too much good stuff. So I'm getting into a few reasons why I think this Russell Westbrook demanding a trade could completely screw over the Rockets, not even just for the short term, but also for the long term going into the future. So I'm getting into all that in this video. If you do like the video at any point, hit the like button and subscribe button. I mean, the absolute world to me. Y'all been showing so much support on the channel lately, and I just appreciate it so much. So yeah, like I said, if you do like the video, hit the like button and subscribe button. I mean, the world to me. And without further ado, without ramming on too much, just get right into this video. All right, so the first thing we get into this video is going to be chemistry is going to be terrible going into this next season. As I mean, if you look at it, Russell Westbrook has demanded a trade. They will most likely trade him, and now you're losing your second best player, which is always going to hurt your chemistry no matter what, and also hurt the confidence of the team that he even wanted to leave. And then also Austin Rivers, he is currently frustrated with James Harden. He has been said that he's not happy with his role and will be testing free agency this season. PJ Tucker also is not happy with his current contract situation, and that has also been verbally said and reported around the league. And then other players also, like Eric Gordon, another player that's just unhappy with his role. And right now, with Eric Gordon being not happy on his role, is very bad for the Houston Rockets, because Eric Gordon is their sixth man for sure. But I mean, also look at it, they just gave him a huge contract, so even if he wants out, no one is going to trade for him, because he is on the wrong side of 30. He is starting to regress, and we already saw that regression already happen a little bit last year. He was a little bit injured last year, bad contract, and he's only a sixth man. No team is going to trade for Eric Gordon at this point, or at least not anything worth Eric Gordon. You're probably gonna end up having to cut him if he gets that upset. So I mean, Eric Gordon's stuck. He doesn't like the role he's currently playing. Austin Rivers will probably be leaving. PJ Tucker doesn't like his contract and is upset, and your second best player on the team is leaving, most likely through a trade. So, I mean, your chemistry is going to just be completely awful. There's just almost no chance that their chemistry is going to be anything good, even if they do return these veterans, because they're going to be frustrated and they're going to be upset. And the reason this is such a big deal, that three huge key players on their team that will be on the team next season most likely, or at least two of those players will be on the team most likely, I mean, that's going to be very hard to do anything with, and it's going to be hard to even fix it, especially when you combine the fact that they have a new head coach that they probably don't know well yet. They probably don't respect him yet, or at least don't respect him onto the level that they would trust him to help fix it. So, I mean, there's just going to be so much chemistry issues, so much unhappiness, so much frustration all among this entire roster. It is going to be very hard to keep this team focused and really help them stay on track to try to win basketball games. It's just going to be very hard to do, and I think there's way too much frustration and chemistry issues on this team for them to be a very successful team in this next up and coming season. Now, my second reason for his deal is going to be that their future is shaky at best. And now, that is probably the nicest way of me saying that. There's a lot of other words you could use, like bad, terrible, not looking good at all. Like, their future is very bleak. As I mean, when they traded for Russell Westbrook, at the time it didn't look that bad. They gave up 4 first round picks, including a 2026 first rounder that is 1-4 protected, and the 2024 first rounder, which is unprotected, to go along with swap rights to their 2021 picks and 2025 picks. So they pretty much gave up their next 4 years worth of picks, which at the time didn't look that bad, because Houston was supposed to be a playoff contender all those years. But now, with Russell Westbrook wanting to leave, this trade is looking like Brooklyn Nets-esque of terribleness and not having picks. Because just think about this. Yes, James Harden is good, but is he good enough to lead a team with no center on the roster, with older, aging guys like Eric Gordon and PJ Tucker, who are all frustrated right now? Is James Harden good enough to lead that team to the playoffs? Because if not, the Oklahoma City Thunder have the rights to almost all those picks that are going to be lottery picks, most likely. So, I mean, this is looking very bad, because this is going to mean they have really no way to get high-quality young guys through the draft, because this year they're going to get swapped. I mean, not this year, they're going to keep it because OKC doesn't want it this year, but then you look at 2024 when they their next pick gives up, that's unprotected. And they're most likely not going to be that good because James Harden's going to be getting older. They're probably going to have a much older roster. Eric Gordon will still be on this team if his contract stays the way it is. And he's going to be like around 35 to 34 at this point. He's probably going to be a shell of what he is right now. So, I mean, that's going to be bad. Like, this team is probably going to be really bad in a few years. And that could be very beneficial for the Oklahoma City Thunder, who got the trade and got those picks, but very detrimental to the Houston Rockets, who made the trade. Like, they could be looking at a Brooklyn Nets type situation, because if you don't know, the Brooklyn Nets tried to form a super team, got rid of all their picks, and they ended up in a very bad situation for many, many years. Well, the Houston Rockets could be in a very, very similar situation if they don't make the right trade with Russell Westbrook. Because, I mean, giving up your entire future for a second-round exit was not what what the Houston Rockets wanted when they made that trade. So the fact that they're already having to get rid of Russell Westbrook completely messes up their entire plans that they already had for the future, and probably how they were going to compensate for getting rid of all those picks. So it's going to be very hard to justify in a few years why they made this trade if they don't find a way to save it or get picked by trading Russell Westbrook. So it's going to be very interesting to see what their future holds, because as of right now, it is looking, like I said, shaky at best. And now my final reason for this view is going to be that they have very, very little leverage now. Because with any superstar demanding a trade, that puts the GM and front office in a very bad situation, because now every team around the NBA knows that that star wants out, so they're not going to be paying as much as they once would for someone like Russell Westbrook. Now, although yes, Westbrook is a little bit under contract right now, and like they do, like teams would want him, and it wouldn't be a one-year rental and things like that, the Rockets are still in a bad situation, because now they know Russell Westbrook is frustrated with his role. He wants out for sure, and he has publicly demanded a trade and publicly said what he wants. He wants to be a floor general. So now that eliminates a lot of teams, because a lot of teams that don't want Russell Westbrook as their main guy, main superstar, is no longer going to trade for him, because Russell Westbrook has already said what he wants to do. So, I mean, that's a lot of teams already canceled out, so that limits the amount of teams that Houston can trade with. But now, also, not only does that limit them, it also makes the teams that they do have left, knowing that they're going to be desperate to get rid of Russell Westbrook, and teams are going to be buying low, which means they're not going to be giving up a lot of picks, they're not going to be giving up a lot of young talent, and that just spells very bad for the Houston Rockets. Because what I think the Houston Rockets need to do, they shouldn't swing for another superstar. That's just not what they should do. Because now with them not having a lot of picks, they should go one of two ways. They should either trade for a lot of young talent, like get a lot of young guys that have a lot of potential, and try to bring them into the team to compensate for losing those picks. Or they should go get first round picks. Or they could do a combination of both, like get less young talent but some more picks on top of it. So I mean, it really depends how they go, but I don't think they should go for another superstar. But now that even limits them even more, because now they're desperate, teams know they're desperate, they can only trade with teams that don't have already a superstar, but they also have to trade for teams that have their first round picks and young talent. So that extremely limits the teams that they can actually trade with. So it's going to be very interesting to see how the Houston Rockets try to navigate through this trade and who they end up trading him to and what for. So I think the Houston Rockets, this trade is going to pretty much determine their future. I think if they try to get an older superstar, their future is going to look very bad, and they're going to be very bad going into the future, at least long term. But if they go for young guys and maybe get some picks, maybe they can salvage their future and be a competitive team for years to come. But unfortunately, guys, that's going to be it for this video. So, comment below. Do you agree with me? Do you think the Houston Rockets are in big trouble? Do you think their future is scary? I want to hear your thoughts in the comment section below. Any video ideas you want to see me make, comment those below as well. It'd mean the absolute world to me. And also hit the like button and subscribe button. Like I said, it helps my videos out a ton. And I cannot thank y'all enough for when y'all do hit the like button and subscribe button. It just means the absolute world to me. But unfortunately, that's going to be it for this video. So, all glory to God. Hope you have a blessed day. Kind of a blessed day. So, you need to have a blessed day. See you in the next video. Goodbye. Boo.